In this video, I would like to caution the potential Android head unit buyers and share the steps to ensure that you are getting the correct hardware specification and Android version when you make a purchase. There has been mismatches that have been reported in both the hardware specification as well as the Android version. This has been more so with the lower variants such as the 2GB, 16GB models, where instead of the 2GB RAM, only 1GB is present. And the Android version mismatches, like you are promised a higher version such as Android 9 or 10, but in reality you are getting a lower version such as Android 6 or 8. This also has been reported. So I would like to caution the potential buyers, be careful. Do not go by Android system information. Install third-party apps from Play Store and check the hardware and Android specifications. If you find an issue, report the issue to the vendor in case of mismatch. Now, not just the Chinese Android head units, but issue with respect to Android version has been reported even in Blaupunkt's Key Largo unit. So I would say be very careful when you purchase Android head units. I would still recommend people to go with Android head units, but make sure you are careful and follow the necessary steps to ensure that you are getting what you are being promised. Hello friends, welcome to yet another video. In this video, we will try to figure out if the configuration as called out by the vendor matches the system settings in terms of RAM configuration, ROM configuration, as well as the Android OS. So this one is a 2GB 32GB Foxfire unit, and it is supposed to be running Android 8.1 Oreo. This is what the vendor had promised at the time of selling this unit. Now I'm going to check the configuration details. So first let us look at the built-in configuration settings, the system info. So as you can see in the system info, it shows Android system 8.1 and RAM of 2GB, flash of 32GB, which is the ROM, and the CPU is shown as A53 1.5 GHz into 4, which means it's a quad core. So now let us try to see if the same figures come out when we try other tools available within the Android ecosystem. So first let us look at the most popular one, which is the CPU-Z app. This is what I had checked at the time of purchasing. So as you can see, the processor matches, it is a Cortex A53. However, if you see here, the speed is shown as 1.25 GHz, so it's an approximation. Although on the system info it shows 1.5 GHz, the actual speed as can be seen on this screen is 1.25 GHz. So this is not a big variation. I would say this is still in the acceptable range. Let's now check the other things. So this is more on the model information, and as we can see here, the RAM and the internal storage are shown here. So the total RAM is 2048 MB, which maps to 2 GB of RAM. So RAM is correct, there is no issue there. And internal storage is shown as 25.62 GB, which was from the promised 32 GB. This is also fine because the formatted space is always lower than the actual quoted space. So the RAM and ROM both are fine. So here if I go to system, again, the Android version is shown as 8.1, which matches with what was told. But the API level, so if you look at the API level, that is shown as 23, which does not map the API level which it should show for Android 8.1. In fact, the API level of 23 is actually for Android 6 Marshmallow. So while the RAM and ROM appear to be correct, the OS seems to be a little bit of a gray area here. So let us try some few other tools that I have here. So I have one more tool which is called as the version info tool. Opening that now. So this one clearly is showing the OS as Marshmallow, right? And if I Now it shows Android version as M and code name, release as 8.1, but the SDK as 20, the SDK version as 23. So it looks like they have actually updated the release version to 8.1, which maps to Oreo, but the API level is still at SDK 23, which means the update has not really happened. This is not actually Android 8.1. Now I'm getting into device info here. So this one kind of detects very well here. So if you see here, it shows it as Android version as 6.0, and in the bracket it is showing as fake 8.1, which means this is not really the promised Android version. It is only 6.0 and not 8.1. So let me now try with one more device info, different software. So let me go to the system here. So as can be seen here, this mismatch is shown, highlighted even here. It is showing as Android 8.1, but the code is shown as Marshmallow, which is for Android 6. So which means it's not a properly updated one. It is still running Android 6 for all practical purposes. So this is what I would recommend, folks. So when you are purchasing an Android head unit, do not go just by the CPU-Z or the system info shown in the system. Try to install some additional apps. So this device info HW, that's a good app that even calls out the specific Android version to be fake also, by detecting if there is a mismatch between the API level and the SDK.